This episode of CHS Pride TV is brought to you by the generous support of Columbia Power and Water. Dedication and commitment to safer power and a better community.
Coming up on this episode of Pride TV,
we'll put Coach Campbell on the hot seat.
Nathan will get a hair makeover.
Dr. Cap, are there ghosts at CHS?
The first ever Pride TV Minecraft building competition.
That's coming up next on this next episode of Pride TV. And live while we're young.
Nathan.
I'm Kenzie.
And I'm Amaya.
Let's start off this episode with a new segment called Hot Seat.
We have some smart teachers here at CHS, but we'll put them to the test and see how smart they really are.
Our first victim, guest on the hot seat is Coach Campbell.
Welcome to our newest segment, Hot Seat. Today for our first guest, we have Coach Campbell. Okay, before we get started, let's remind you of the rules. You have 15 seconds to answer each question, and once you get three wrong, you're done. So let's get started. What does WWW stand for in a website browser?
World Wide Web.
Good, good. What can be broken but is never held?
A mirror.
A promise. What comes down but never goes up?
A balloon. Rain.
Rain is correct. What is the rarest M&M color?
Yellow.
Wrong, it's brown.
Do I have any lifelines? Can I call a friend?
No. What is cynophobia?
Anybody have any answers? Can I ask the audience? Pass.
Someone's giving you a hint.
Sounds like a dog.
It is the fear of dogs.
Is there a dog in here?
Who is Mickey Mouse's girlfriend?
Oh, that's a tough one. Minnie Mouse.
What type of fish is Nemo?
Oh, I haven't seen that movie in 2 decades. Pass.
Okay.
How many passes do I get?
Really none, but...
Oh.
How many pairs of wings do bees have?
One.
That is incorrect. It is two. Oh. You are now done. But we have one more final question for you. What teacher would you like to see next in the hot seat?
Coach Stone.
Okay. Thank you for joining us on Hot Seat.
Pride TV. I'm Kinsey.
I'm Amaya.
I'm Kamaria.
And I'm Nathan.
Welcome to the Pride TV Hair Salon.
And today we're going to be flat ironing and styling Nathan's hair.
So I can get some new lady friends.
Stars through the night. halfway done, so we're gonna switch it off to Super Maya.
Hey guys.
What's up, homie?
What's up? What you think?
I have no idea what it looks like. I haven't seen it yet. I need a mirror of some sort.
We don't have a mirror.
Oh my God!
Nathan, what did you think about your braids?
I liked them. They were a bit different. I thought they were pretty cool looking.
We'll be right back after this short break.
Make sure you're following us on all social medias at CHS Pride TV for more content like this. There were nights of endless pleasure. It was more than all your loss in love. Baby, 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 when you touch me like this, when you hold me like that, it was gone with the wind, but it's all coming back to me. When you see the free of my life. He's all alone, some things will never change. The lonely loner seeks the freedom at night. At night.
About some spooky visitors that may have shown up at CHS.
We spoke to Mr. Brown about some paranormal investigations right here at school.
My name is Garland Brown. I'm the criminal justice teacher here at Central High School. I've been here for 26 years now. what you are seeing or hearing me say is something that we heard from custodians, former teachers who worked here, former students that worked here. And over the years, including my first year teaching here, we heard stories about Central High School being haunted. One of the videos I'm gonna pull up and show y'all. That night in particular, that was 2012. That night in particular, we had a sprite and a full body apparition appearing in a library that stood in front of the trap camera and took a picture. That was pretty interesting. So it took us a number of years to get together a team of people who were serious enough and scientific enough to come in and get data to come into the school building to do another, what we call a paranormal investigation. Now that crew is the Volunteer State Paranormal Research Society, led by a man by the name of Mike Sear. And all the way up to 2015 when we tore down the old building. And actually, we did one in 2016 right before they tore the building down. So they had been in this building and were very familiar with this building. And it got to the point where they would ask for Mike. They were asking for him to come here. As I said, the lady who was the medium in the last paranormal investigation, she claimed to have seen Senator Withorn. And how we diagnosed that process, she said, I've seen him at your door. She said, the first time I came here, he was at your back door at the metal building. And I was like, what? And it was kind of strange because when she drew a picture of him, I recognized that picture because Senator Withorn's picture is downtown at the school board. And I said, that person looks familiar. And I pulled his picture up. I said, is this who you saw? And she said, that's exactly who I saw and who's been following us tonight. The strangest story that I've heard, or the scariest story that I've heard since we've been here, was the first year we were in the building, we did Lion Wing. And we did Lion Wing here, and that was before they finished the gym and band room part. So they were still working on that, so we did it in the main building. There was a lady that told me in the car rider line the next day, she said that she came in the car rider line. I mean, she was leaving the school. She had parked over on the side beside where the teachers parked. And she said she saw a girl sitting on the sidewalk crying. And she said this girl was just boo-hoo crying outside. And she was like, I wonder what's wrong with her. And she said she started to say something to her, but she didn't. So she gets in the car, starts the car up. And she, the way they had traffic running, it was one way in, so she had to go out down at the side where everybody comes in at now to get out. And when she was turning left, and she saw the girl sitting there on the marquee crying. And she was like, she said, let me go find out what's wrong with her because she, you know, something ain't right. And she gets up to her and said, the girl, she was crying. She comes up, walked up to her, she said, young lady, what's wrong? And she said, she looked up at him. When she took her fat hands down from her face, she didn't have any eyes. And she said she jumped back like this and ran back to the car. And when she got in the car, she looked back and the girl was gone.
Do we have any spirits here that like to speak with us tonight?
Whether you believe in ghosts or not, those stories are pretty hard to explain.
I hope I never run into any ghost in this building.
Speaking of building, Detrevion and Kinsey had a Minecraft building competition.
I think I won. Check it out.
Welcome to Pride TV. I'm Kinsey, and today we're doing a Minecraft build-off challenge.
How's she just gonna forget about me? My name is Detrevion. Welcome. I am going to win this challenge because I play Minecraft.
No.
Says who?
Says me.
Says you?
Feel like sun on my skin. This is love. No, it is. I know it sounds super cliche, but you make me feel some type of way. This is falling, falling
in love. My name is Malik.
And I'm Amaya.
And we're judging Minecraft buildings.
First up is Travion's house.
It's brown. It's brown.
It's very small. But it's very well built.
Yeah,
it's like there's crackles on the outside. But it works.
Okay, the interior looks nice. Mm-hmm. I like the painting.
I do too. I like the little chests on the wall.
Why is there a skeleton?
What is it sitting in? That was a nice touch to that. That was a nice app. Nice touch.
Okay.
It's giving, but it's empty.
Yeah.
It's very empty.
I like the interior, but you could have put more effort into it.
And the floor, too.
You literally could have put more effort into this.
And the carpet. It looks like a bubble bee threw up in there.
This is Mackenzie's house, her building.
Yes, it's. As you can see, it's very much bigger than the Travion's.
Yeah, it's very large.
Very. It's very nice.
Okay, let's see.
I like the stairs. They're cute.
I just built them. Okay. So very, the floor is...
Yes, I love the floor. I love the pattern.
It's very
of it.
Colorful, yes.
Yes. I don't know.
Wish there was furniture, but that's okay.
It's kind of empty for
yeah,
a big
it's
house.
Kinda, yeah, it's very empty for a very big house.
But like, I like it, you know?
Let's see what this is over here.
Okay, Ooh. We have a bathroom. Okay. The bathroom is very nice.
Where's the water? Where's the water?
I wish I had a bathroom like this in my house. But this is a very nice bathroom.
Yes, yes.
You did it's very good.
It's
okay.
It's a very nice bathroom.
You did
bathroom.
Very good on the bathroom. Okay, so this is my bedroom in Kinsey's house. Okay. It's kind of empty at the bottom, but
yeah.
I love it.
Yeah.
And I love the little stairs. Oh, there's a bookshelf.
There is. It's very low.
It's
like,
very. It's
kind of low.
Empty. But I really like it. I just
Very
am glad that she
empty.
Contributed me into
yes,
the house.
Yes.
So what's over here?
The dining table.
Yes. Oh,
I forgot which one's my chair.
Right.
This one's
right
my
there.
Chair.
Okay, so is mine the one with like the chicken and the potato?
Yeah.
Okay, so that one's mine, and I love it. Oh, and I
Whose is this
okay.
one?
That's mine.
Okay. Whose is this
we
one?
We don't talk about that one.
Yeah, we don't talk about that one.
Okay.
Don't ask questions.
This is my room?
Yeah.
Dang, I'm right in front of the kitchen. Don't play with me when I get hungry.
Oh, it's so cute.
I'm looking around, and I got a pink bed, too, because pink's my favorite color. Like, come on now.
Aw.
And then this is...
It's a lamp.
Then you go to your left.
Ooh.
It's very spacious.
Yes,
I love the little
very
cats.
Spacious. The books and everything, the cats.
I love the little kitty cats. So, aw.
There.
Oh, the little flowers.
It is it's very, very light. I said I was saying colorful. Light.
I love
a variety
how,
of flowers.
Yes, I was just gonna say I love how there's a variety of
And
them.
Then the library, come on now, like
And she even has like the name of which one is which.
Let's take a look
that.
At the grass at the top. Let's take a look at the grass at the top.
Oh my god, stop, that's so cute.
It is. This is like very like
And with like the little ladders. Can you go up the ladders?
Yeah.
So now we're gonna go view the theme park.
Oh, this is Mackenzie's room. This used to be a pool.
She filled it in with popcorn, but it's okay.
Yeah, she did.
Overall thoughts on both houses. The Travion's was cute and like cozy, and I really did like it, but it was just very empty. It didn't make sense. And I feel like Kinsey's house was very well put together and more colorful and had more things in it. So I'm gonna vote for Kinsey's house.
I like the Travion's, but it was just. It could have been more. It could have been more. Like, it was just boring. Like, it was very well furnished, but it was just boring. Like,
yes.
Boring. Mackenzie's was fun. Like, she had my room. She had her room. She had cats.
Right.
She literally had, like, a rock floor in the library. Like, the cherry on. It's a little cozy house. Yeah,
yeah.
I vote for Kinsey.
Yeah, me too.
Sorry to Travion.
You are excellent Minecraft architects. Those are looked great.
See, I told you I won. Thanks to Travion for bringing in his PS4 so we could build.
That's all we have for this episode of Pride TV.
Be sure to follow us on TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter at CHS Pride TV.
We'll see you next time on Pride TV.
Bye! And live while we're young.